Bees have one of the most striking examples of organization within the animal kingdom. They achieve massive efficiency by dividing their resources into reproductive and non-reproductive efforts. The leader of this organization is the queen, who lays all the eggs within the hive. Once they are laid, the eggs develop into larvae and eventually pupae. Most bees enter the working stage of their lives as hive bees. As they get older, they take on more complex roles, such as foraging to bring back pollen for the colony. The future queen is chosen at just 3 days old, and their diet is immediately changed from nectar to royal jelly. Queens are significantly larger than a normal bee. They live longer, and they are the only female in the hive with fully developed ovaries. Queens enter the reproductive stage of their lives just 16 days after they are laid. This begins by making their one and only trip out of the hive, where they mate with many drones. Once they return, they remain in the hive for the rest of their life, laying up to 2,000 eggs a day. Despite extensive research, it is still unknown if queens are chosen by a social factor or a predetermined genetic basis. However, in 2011, Masaki Kamakura made an important discovery when he determined how royal jelly induces the worker-to-queen change. After being stored for 30 days, Kamakura observed that the effects of royal jelly had completely degraded. He isolated different elements of royal jelly and tested their properties, and found that the protein 57-kDa matched this behavior. This protein was designated as royalactin, the factor in royal jelly that induces queen differentiation. However, bees are not a typical model organism, and Kamakura needed access to a wider knowledge bank to finish his research. Surprisingly, he found that royal jelly induces the same morphological changes on Drosophila as the bees, making them the perfect match to continue his testing on. To uncover the signaling pathway of royalactin, Kamakura used both RNA interference and the Gal-4 system. RNA interference is used to manipulate gene expression by degrading target mRNA strands before they can be translated into proteins. A complementary double-stranded copy of the target gene is made and inserted into the cell. The enzyme dicer breaks the strand into segments called small interfering RNA, or siRNA strands. The siRNA strands are then transported by the complex RISC to the target mRNA. The two strands bind and the mRNA is degraded. The Gal-4 system is another method of isolating specific genes to determine the role of the proteins they express. First, the Gal-4 gene is placed under the control of an enhancer in a specific gene. An upstream activation sequence, or UAS, which is under the control of the Gal-4 gene product, is placed into the genome of another fly. The two are crossed to produce an individual with both the Gal-4 and the UAS segments. The expression of the Gal-4 gene will drive the activation of the UAS segment, and ultimately the expression of the reporter gene. The reporter gene produces a phenotype that can be easily observed, such as green dye. Using this system, the role of each gene can be detected by observing where the resulting proteins are being produced. By altering the production of specific proteins in flies using these two techniques, Kamakura was able to observe the resulting changes in phenotype until he found the pathway that produces the same results as royalactin. He found that royalactin acts through a signaling pathway that begins with epidermal growth factor receptors. Once their respective growth factors bind to them, they form dimers, setting off a range of responses in the cell that ends with the activation of specific kinases that control growth and development. These kinases include SK6, which increase the body size of the Drosophila by increasing their cell size, as well as MAPK, which reduce their developmental time. Scientists have been trying to figure out this pathway for years, so Kamakura's paper drew quite the attention upon publication. In particular, Butsed and colleagues had repeated the original experiment with significantly less successful results, and even larvae death when testing some of the proteins Kamakura had claimed to be vital. This prompted him to publish once again in order to defend his original work, arguing that Butsed didn't see results because their larvae were not supplied with enough royalactin to produce queen differentiation. Bees are important pollinators of many plants, so without them, a large portion of ecosystem diversity is threatened. This also includes global food security, since they pollinate many of our crops as well. Unfortunately, bees are under global threat, with their populations decreasing rapidly. Each bee is crucial to the smooth running of a hive, but queens are particularly important since they are the only ones capable of producing offspring. The discovery of the signaling pathway that Royalactin takes would allow us to replicate this process and generate queens ourselves, helping us to guarantee the continuation of this species and the many others that rely on them.